some of the walk around kind of shows some of the things that we have that are very expressed and all in shorts, so hopefully you can see me. Please kind of talk about some of the things that we have to work with and what you yourself to do while you are out in your own field, hopefully when no one's looking. And you can assess some of the things that we've been discussing today. You can actually look through yourself on your own contract tests and stuff that we'll be giving away. Take it back over here. But that way you can go out in your own field and kind of look through yourself at how you are doing it under your management and how your field is reacting. And so, when you go out in the field, when you're out doing your irrigation, it's on the ground, not shovel. That's one of the first places to start. Is that go ahead and when you're out in the field, take your shovel and dig real down deep, thinking about the root zone of your plant, and pull it up. And what you want to do is when you dig a good soil sample, dig a good handful, get a good flag, get dirt spots, something like that, or whatever it is. And what you want to look for is when you pick these up is the structure, how it looks, what's going on. Are there wormholes? Is it just falling apart in your hand? Keeping in mind that if it's falling apart, it's probably going to be reacting a lot like these soils here. As you pick them up, if they don't hold together, if they don't have a crumb structure, if you're clear down to the small, fine grain of your soil, what happens is every time it rains, or every time you irrigate, that water falls apart, as we had it here in the slate test. And what happens is when that soil falls apart, it gets to the point where it creates a seal in your soil because the soil particles gather together and your water cannot get to your soil. That's including your irrigation water, and if you're on dry land, that's the lifeblood of what your plant needs on dry land, is that rainwater to get down and get to your plant root. So if your soil is falling apart, what happens is that water moves through your soil to the point where all the soil falls apart and it creates an impenetrable layer. And so if you're picking up your soil and it's falling apart, it's going to take an extra long time for that water to get through your soil. And if the water's sitting towards the top as we get in our summer rains and you get a hot day or after a rainstorm, a lot of that water just went through your soil down to evaporate it off. So also when you have soil in your hand, get a good smell. You want a good, healthy smell of your soil. That's going to show you kind of the biological life of soil in there. We actually have some stuff up here to do the slate test. So if you guys would like, there are a bunch of these screens right here to cut for you. Go ahead and take one. And if you have a chance, I mean, a lot of people will suppose get a jar, except you do, you can. And what you're going to do is you're going to bend down. You want to put your screen enough where you can take a dirt plot out of your field. Fill up the water and make sure that when we put the soil in, that the dirt plot is fully covered with water. Now, to get the best result when we take your samples, it is best if the dirt plot is dry. So go ahead and, when you're out digging soil, get a good clump, put it in the truck, or don't disturb it, just let it dry out. Because what's going to happen is when that water, when the dirt plot is dry, and the water goes in, it's going to show you exactly what's happening here. Is your soil going to stick together? Is it going to slowly disintegrate and fall apart? So again, if you haven't had a chance today, come up here and look at these. You know, all our conventional tills all fell apart. The biology is not there in that soil to hold that together. We've destroyed that and destroyed that and destroyed that. And when we get into the less disturbance, low disturbance, the no-till, the cover crop ones, they're holding together. The biology is there. So as we've talked about the biology today, keep in mind that that is the life component of the soil and what's going to feed crop. The NRCS, each office, has the ability to measure that biology in your soil. It's a greater test. What we do is we go, and if you'd like, you can contact your NRCS office. We can come out. We have a whole lot of soil assessment tools that are back here that kind of show you between measuring whole things in your compaction of your soil. But this is specific to the biology of your soil. We're going to stick a can in your soil. We're going to seal it off. And after 30 minutes, we're going to find out how much carbon dioxide is produced by those living organisms in your soil. And we can show you how well your soil is doing. You know, is there something there? You'd be surprised in finding soils. If you have a high temperature, low moisture, and typically those conventional till, and then even higher than in the dryland soil, you can find those temperatures are really, really high. It's really good. If you have a chance, you can get a little thermometer. If your soil is over 85 degrees, you are losing more water in evaporation. At some point, when you're in 100 degree range, your biology of your soil is greatly affected, and it's actually reduced. So keeping that fat layer, these are kind of the principles that we talk about today, keeping the ground covered, feeding that biology. If you're leaving it there naked and running a fever, we're killing off the biology. So these are just some tools. NRCS, and also we can look at your pH and your EC, so your salt content in soil. So again, what you can do personally is if you can ever get a ring or any type, just cut yourself a little pipe like this, put it halfway in the ground. If you want to see how long your soil can take water, bury a pipe, like I said, halfway in the ground, take some rubber plastic, and put it over top and push that plastic down, and then get some water. And so if you're irrigating corn, you put on an inch and a quarter, you kind of put it over, or even less, check yourself. Time yourself and see how well your soil can take the water. Is it going to run off? Are you already cut it slow? So what you do is you put that metal back and you pack it down the soil, you get your phone out, and you get your timer out, and you put your water on, you measure it, you want that inch of water, whatever your irrigation is, put it on at the time. You get your timer ready. Pull that plastic out and start climbing. And see how well your soil can take your water, whether it be rainwater or irrigation water. Now, one of the things that showed was Dave Brown. When he first started this, his soil was taking half an inch of water per hour. After doing cover crops, practicing the no-till and the soil principles, he can get 8 inches an hour. Now, I helped with the farm in the world, and I did this on our own soil. This year, we grow grain corn out there. And I got 1/4 inch of water to get through my soil in 35 minutes. And I'm wondering, why in the heck is my corn on this high and always starving for water? My pivot's big enough, and we can't get around quick enough to get back to it. And it comes down to the basic simple, if we're looking at this and then we can get out to the fields, if that soil is over-tilled and falling apart, that water is not getting your soil. And our temperature of our soil that day was 95 degrees, it's not very hot, it's running off. So keep those in mind. Always pay a shovel, just look. Just take a chance to look. You can do this with rocks. And I would recommend doing this right after irrigation because when the ground is fully saturated, you can go through the soil pretty easy. Let it dry out a little bit, like in a normal setting, and then try to put a rod through your soil. And what that's going to happen, if you can find your passion there, if you're doing any tillage and plowing and disking, you will find little plowing. Every law of physics is for every up, there's a down. As your plow or your disc comes through the ground, that bottom shear creates an up, lift the soil up, but it also creates a down pressure. And so every plow there, you'll be able to find. If you stick this rod up to a half inch or whatever you need in rebar, you'll feel that. And at some point, if it's good enough compaction there, you won't be able to penetrate through that. And if you want to think about it in a real perspective, as you guys rely on the crops to pay for your lives, if you can't get a good root, that root's not going to get the water and nutrients it needs to grow. And so what happens is that root is growing through the ground and it hits that compaction layer, it can't go any deeper. So what happens is it starts to grow horizontal, side to side. So the one hole in my hand is a bit of anything we see on these. This is a penetrometer. NRCS office is going to get attention that they have these. This is another way to measure your compaction in your soil. And there's a little gauge out there. And it shows you that we're running between 200 to 300 pounds per square inch to push this through. The plant roots are starting to be restricted to get your compaction. If you hit 300 PSI, 300 pounds per square inch, most all roots stop. And so, on your own time, when you want that NRCS, if someone else is off, get out there in the dark and push your rod from the ground. See what it does on your own float. If your neighbor's not looking, go over to his field and see how it is on his field too. See what the manager is doing in the Atlantic. So then, we do have some literature today. And I don't know, a little questionnaire that you can take. These are pre-papers, just go ahead and take it. There's going to be a bunch of questions. You can score yourself on how your soil is doing. It's going to have a lot of questions on it. So there are some literature over here that you can grab that can help you assess that. So, again, if you'd like access, we do have all the tools, specifically the ones up here, that if you want systems, and if you want to kind of show you the other samples that we can run, we can come out with a little anytime, a lot of person. Also, what I'm going to talk about right here, we talked about in some of the presentations of the 6 to 8 inches, or 6 to 8 weeks of growth. These two boxes with these plants, all right, that range, between 6 to 8 inches of growth. And what I want everyone to look at is the diversity of the crops, and we have 4 feet of soil. If you look down there, you can see they have worms in there. The worm holes, but if you look clear down at the bottom, there are roots clear down to 4 feet. And so by diversifying our cover crops, practicing the principle we've been talking about today, when that is that annual crop is done, that root begins to decompose. Those are now going to be available for next year's plant root growth to take advantage of that, obtain the nutrients that were in that last year's existing root, but be able to have a chance to grow. Every time we fail, we destroy those, so we cut them off. So if you have a chance to come up here with a box, you do have a few different species that you look at, and again, you look to see the plant roots and the depths. So, again, keep in mind, if you like, another way of always looking at your soil, or doing your soil test, USU Extension can help with that as well. Keeping in mind that the main test they have is just to look at the physical and chemical properties, so we're going to tell you what your soil is, if it's a sand loam, clay loam, and then we're going to tell you your chemical, your NPK, your nutrients. If you want to look at your biology, and if you want to look at kind of what we talked today, you have to go after a Haney test. There are a few other different tests that you can look into. If you talk about potentially or NRCS, and we kind of help you with that, what you're looking for that. If you'd like to see where your soil is at, you've actually seen some of the printouts from their soils this year, or from the past years of what they've been able to obtain. So, more welcome again. You can take the, and there's more screen if you want, and try that soil test on your own.
Possibly soil test.
We cost state, depending on what we order, talk to cost state. Any test is about $49. So if you look at all the carbon, your available organic nitrogen, the different aspects of it, it's actually giving you a rating.